Hi World TV, I'm Vaughan Lee. Welcome to the UTC. I'll show you around. This is me. This is the reception area of the UTC. When you come through, you get greeted by a member of staff like Silk or Asim over there. We've got a chill out zone over here where people can just chill, play the computer, play UFC 2011. You can do laptop stuff, you can just chill, have a protein shake, cup of tea, coffee, whatever you want. I'll show you the shop. We're sponsored by Bad Boy, I'm sponsored by Bad Boy and two other fighters, and we stock the Bad Boy stuff and clothing range in our shop. Do cool stuff. Also sponsored by USN, if you want to come around and check this out. We've got a wide range of protein supplements. Very good to recover and build muscle, depending on what you want to do. I'll show you, this is mat zone one, as you can see up here. This is a matted area where anyone can use when you come around. We do morning classes on here. All the walls are padded. We've got cage walls over here as well to work your functional cage craft off it. Got pads, got bags, got balls. We do kids classes as well, fitness classes, that kind of stuff. They incorporate all these kind of medicine balls and stuff like that. I show you the weights. We've got a weighted area. We've got machinery, machine weights. We've got free weights as well. It's not really a bodybuilder's gym, it's a martial arts kind of gym, so you can get fit the fighting way, do you know what I mean? You want to see big meatheads in here, but I don't really want that. Around here, we've got some more machines. Now we're going to see, check out some of our guys rolling in the cage.
Yay, yay!
Let's go. Okay, guys, time. This is Steve Taylor, soon to be champ. This is Sean Kelly, again, soon to be champ. And this is Silky Smooth, again, another champ.
My second fight was 3 weeks ago against a kid named Mark Marsham. You might know his brother, he's Jack Marshman, from a family of professional boxers. He's 7-0 in the MMA world at the moment. He was supposed to be another up-and-coming British star, debuted for the UFC, and the same again. I nearly stopped him 3 times, but he's a tough kid, but beat him easy enough as well. By unanimous decision.
I'm more of a stand-up fighter. I like using my hands, my speed, my power. But my ground game is probably just as good. I'd class myself as a well-rounded fighter. But I do like, prefer to finish fights. Not, I don't like to grind them out. I like to get in there and get the job done. I fought some well-known fighters, such as Nathan Beer, who's a known fighter out of Wales. I fought Leon Del Garcia, who's another well-respected fighter in the MMA. I fought on such shows as Anger Management, and my last show I fought on was Fight UK. I fought on Fight UK 3, which I thought was the best show I've ever fought on, to be fair. And I'm going to be fighting for the title on Fight UK 5 in November.
My mixed martial arts background originated in boxing when I was a little kid. But for the last 3 years I've been studying jiu-jitsu, no-gi, grappling. More recently I've started to put everything together in the last 12 to 18 months. Thai boxing, wrestling, basically mixing everything up together, putting it all into one package.
This is Mark Hardwick, one of the gym owners and my manager and the brains behind the whole organisation.
The idea came from basically we went on a trip to America and witnessed the facilities that the American fighters were training in, and basically wanted to bring that concept to the UK. So basically we cater for, it's all things that a fighter needs under one roof. That's basically our concept to UTC. Basically UTC is we're a family. So it doesn't really matter what sort of background you come from, if it's wealthy, poor, white, black, it makes no difference. When a guy steps on the mat in the UTC, it's an equaliser. We're just, You know, we're all equal, we're all friends, and it's just one goal, one vision, and that's just to be successful at what we do, which is competing mixed martial arts.
My name's Asim Mohak, my record's 0-1, and I'm about to fight in about 4 weeks' time. I'm more of a wrestler, starting to work a bit of my jiu-jitsu now, and my boxing as well.
We've got runners, and we've got aerodynes. This is our like full-size cage. I fought in cages smaller than this. Do you know what I mean? So it's awesome to train in, do you know what I mean? The floor's really nice, the cage is cool. So it's really important to train in a cage if you're fighting in a cage. Get used to that ring craft kind of stuff, using the cage. Got hand aerodynes. Really good for that punching endurance and that wrestling cardio kind of thing. We've got VersaClimber. If you've used a VersaClimber before, you know they're a pain. Ah, we've got a grappler here. This is awesome. Awesome for your like, it gives you that gorilla strength in your forearms, your chest, your shoulders. It works all your upper body, your back, do you know what I mean? You can pull it down, you can stand up, you can work it up like this as well. It gives you that good grappling strength and endurability. Over here, we've got a keg. We lift. All this is like functional weights. We've got kettlebells. We've got this, we call it the G2, the grappler 2, where we can just twist and stuff like this. And it's all good for your core and functional power, or for when you're striking and stuff like that, and wrestling, of course. Yeah. I use this kind of stuff a lot because it's all functional, do you know what I mean? It's not really stationary stuff. You have to use more than one part of your body to lift the weight kind of thing. Do you know what I'm saying? This is our boxing ring. It's a pretty big boxing ring. You can run around a lot in there. It's pretty big. Again, I've fought in smaller boxing rings. I bet most fighters have. But it's a nice one to, if you're doing a boxing fight or a kickboxing fight, or you're fighting MMA in a ring, do you know what I mean? It's always good to train in that kind of environment that you're training for. Okay, I'm gonna show you upstairs because we do have it upstairs. Follow me through. Who's this guy? This is a bigger matted area where we do most of the wrestling and jiu-jitsu classes up here, and we do loads of sparring sessions up here as well.
My name is Leonard Edwards. My record is 8-0, 7-pro, 1-0 pro. Say no names, just fight whoever comes in front of me. I don't really go out and look for fights. Whoever comes, I fight. Hopefully, when I get to the USA, fight for the title. That's my aim in life, that's what I want to do. It's like the peak, isn't it? Like, where we're aiming to be. Like, that's like the big stage. Everyone get to know your name, where all the money is. So that's the aim, really, isn't it, in life, for me anyway.
Well, well, well.
Serious.
You'll get a punch in the nose like blam.
What?
You'll get a big nose bleed like blam.
Ow.
You'll get a grip on the floor like blam.
Yeah.
Track your face across the curb like blam.
Yeah.
Now bring you in the road like blam. You'll get elbow drop like well, well, well.
Serious.
My name's Sean Jackson, and I've got my first fight coming up. I haven't fought MMA before yet. I've done an interclub, and that's it really. Well, I'm fighting at middleweight, 84 kilograms, and not really, no. There's no names. I'll just fight whoever comes along. Yeah, I'd fight Tom Kong Watson, sorry. Yeah, he's just the same. He's the same as everyone else, really. He bleeds, made of skin and bone, flesh. He's just a normal person. I'll just do MMA because I enjoy it. And it's just something I enjoy doing here at the UTC gym. If I could get into like some of one of the bigger shows in the future, I'll try, but for now, just doing what I do, just having fights and just enjoying myself, really.
Yeah, I was scheduled to fight Eric Perez on Bama. I was training for that fight, but then I got the call from UFC. And when you get the call from UFC, everything doesn't matter anymore. That's where you go, you know? Well, before when I started off, you've got a job, then you only can train certain times of the day, so you have to train early in the morning before you go to work and stuff, and then you have to work all day, and then train again in the evening, do you know what I mean? Which is tired, because you can't give you 100% because you've been working all day and stuff, depending on what kind of job you got. Most people are laborers and stuff like that, so it takes all the energy out of them. But when you get to a higher level and you get sponsors like USN and stuff like that, the UTC sponsor me as well. So they sponsor me to be a full-time fighter, which then I can train, I can rest, I can train. Because I'm at a level now where these guys are professional fighters and they're doing the same. They're training, eating, sleeping, and then training again. Do you know what I mean? They're recovering. Recovery time is really important. So that's what these guys are giving me the opportunity to do as well. So I need to train like a thoroughbred fighter and just concentrate on my fighting. This is UFC, you only get like one shot at this.